Yo guys, today we're gonna play one of my favorite games of all time. You probably understood, but by reading the description. So, yeah. The thing is, we're going create a new. Let's take monster. Let's take second one. What we gotta do is just play the game with two sheets. I know you guys are cheating again, but I can't play any game either. The thing is, I just want to cheat, that's all. No, the thing is that I used a sheet with seeds. I'm gonna use one of each seed every start of an episode. So when I use those seeds, should probably not talk it into. Since they're not talking either way and just some text popping up, then I think it doesn't hurt that much to talk. So I've used one of each seed every time I start the game or begin to record an episode, and I have money sheets too. So those are the two things I have on. So and there's a little hamster rat thingy thing. There's gonna be little glitches here and there. Comes with a new recorder, new stuff. So, like here, and then it's go back to normal. There will be like glitches in towns and stuff too, just because there's so much. The recorder has to record, so. Oh my god! Genghis is the best. Do you see something weird around his hands? I don't know what that is happening. But I will fix that in next episode. Or I will figure out next episode. So we use one of these. One of these. And one of these. One of these. And one of these. And here we go. Get 5 skill points. Let's take sword. Most people probably recommend boomerang, because I can hit more than one target at the beginning of the game. So sometimes that's pretty good. But you know, the sword is more awesome. And let's go talk to these guys. God damn it. Enough, No, slimies! Yep, let's take them head on. Let's just start with attacks. Die. Die. And die. And enemies are defeated. If you can't beat slimes, then you should probably do something else. If you have a hard time beating slimy slimes. Thank goodness you're safe, Maldia. So scary, so scary. Scenario and game design, Yuji Horii. Yuri. Character and monster design, Akira Toriyama. Music composer, Koichi Sugiyama. Director, Akihiro Hino. And here's a little frame drop and shite. If you guys notice, feels like things are a bit slower. Yes, I will. Oh, good. Yes, you save it, church. There's few things you can do. We can buy. I think we can buy armors here. Might be something that might help us here. Yep. I guess Youngest is the only one to carry. And I can carry a little armor. Let's do that. Yep. Both of us can wield a little shield, so we're gonna do that. Defense, defense! And we got everything on. Great. So now we're gonna give one to Youngest, one to Youngest, one to Youngest again, even though he's so fucking weak. He's so fucking weak right now, but later on in the game he's gonna become OP as fuck though. Let's take clubs for now. Yep. Nice, nice. Now we got some high defenses here. Let's go to... We could actually continue straight here and buy some Chimera wings. Let's buy 9 of these, yes. Put in the bag. This by 9. Let's do that. And this by. Youngest gets 5 of those now. Let's put those in the bag. And this one is we're gonna have to teleport to different areas later on. Until we learn swoosh, I think it's called. Not 100% sure if this is called swoosh. Excuse me. Okay, this is the weapon shop. Here we can buy our so-called first gear. Oaken club. Let's put one giant mullet for Youngest. And so Youngest got his weapon equipped. We're gonna buy, as you can see, this one actually has one more damage than this. But the thing is, since I upgraded, that I had 5 on the swords, I did 5 more extra damage. So, but I will buy one boomerang after all, because we can upgrade to metal boomerang later on in an easy way, if I remember how to do it though. What the hell is going on? Stop it. Stop it. Now we're gonna continue out here. So we're going to the church. We're gonna save just for sake of it. Yes, let's save. Let's see. Yeah, I got another save. Early on memory one. We might use that one instead of this one. It's exactly the same. Just that. I don't know. We see about that. I might actually level up to level 10 off screen for you guys. So. You can actually read books. You might learn recipes and stuff in the bookshelf. So it's a good idea to just go around every bookshelf. Fuck's sake, can do talk today. So you can loot the closet and stuff. I don't know why you can loot the closet and stuff, but you can. I think you need fifth key here. Yep. And to make fifth key, we need nail and something else. I don't remember the exact. But as you can see, there's nothing here. But after we've done the main quest and defeat the first boss, we're going to go back here. And there will be something on the ground up in the tower. Call blimey. I don't know why I fucking say that, but whatever. So we're gonna continue here. You see this guy standing there? He's like watching down the well, then you like jump down. You will find a chest, a little shield. So I did have to buy two, but what the hell? We can have two. There are a few places you can find stuff like here. You can find okay, that's the wrong room. But close, it was pretty close. that's the bar. Right here. I am pretty sure this place, yeah, here. I don't think you can open this too. But does it always but if it, when you get the fifth key, you get back here. I think there's a weapon in one of those, so you might get. I don't remember if it's a good weapon, but there is a weapon. And
haven't you had enough, Mr. Calderasha's hair? Sorry, but I've got a business to run.
What? My fortune, Jerry? Haphazard! Are you a complete fool? Let me tell you something. All fortune telling is haphazard.
I don't follow. If you're saying you knew about the fire, shouldn't you at least have warned Master Rylus?
Yes, poor Rylus. How many times I argued with him on that. I cannot believe he's gone.
Creepy as fuck. Say what?
Just come and see! The whole town's gone crazy!
Monster, let's go and kill it then. Motherfucker. Yeah. Freight dropped like fucking crazy. I know I haven't fixed the recorder perfectly, but what else cares? Is that it's so bad that the whole fucking thing is fucked up? So. It will happen when there are many things on the screen. Look lively! Yeah, he looked at me! Oh, it's hideous! God damn it!
Get out, monster! You're not welcome here!
Get out, monster! Get out, monster! You're not welcome here! Ow! Oh, ow! Chicken nuggets! If women ever throw stones back in the face on all of them. That was a fine reception. God damn it.
Did you manage to find Master Rylus? What? He's dead? Oh, no, no, no! Well, I suppose there's no point crying over spilled milk. It's Dormagus we're after. He's the one who cursed the princess and I, after all. I had hoped
I'm quite annoyed with the finger. The finger!
We'll just have to track Dormagus down by ourselves. With Rylus gone, we have nothing further to gain from staying here. Let's be on our way.
Wait.
Please wait. I'm sorry to come running after you like this. It's just that I wanted to ask you a favor.
Are you not afraid of me, young lady?
I dreamt about you.
So weird.
Some people came to town with a strange creature. It was sort of halfway between a human and a monster.
Are you referring to me?
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to be rude.
Not to worry. I've had worse things said to me today. You know, you remind me of my Medea. You're about the same age. Anyway, you say you had a dream about me. Most peculiar.
I'm sorry. I haven't even introduced myself. I'm Valentina, daughter of the great fortune teller Caldarasha. If you could just come to my house, I'll explain everything there. It's by the well, at the far end of town. I'll be waiting.
I'll be waiting for you.
Magnificent! She wasn't afraid to look at me at all! Not one bit!
so annoying. That finger is so annoying. I need to fix that next episode. So what now then? Let's go. Let's go up here. Might it be this house? Maybe. That is all right, but okay.
I must have drifted off. How rude of me. I wanted to ask you a favor about this crystal ball. Sorry.
I have two crystal balls. damn. Nah, it's not important.
I'll carry on then. My father, Galda Rasha, was once a really famous
She did it either way.
Lost treasure, missing people. There was nothing the great Galda Rasha couldn't help people with, but then one day, he lost his powers. All of a sudden, nothing he foretold turned out to be true anymore. It's probably because he stopped using a real crystal ball.
A real crystal ball.
Oh, Elgina, what is going on here? How many times have I told you not to touch my crystal ball? What? Aren't you that? What brings you here? Yeah. I do not know what my daughter has asked, but you can forget it. I do not need your help. I am fine as I am. I am going to. Valentina, say your farewells. Show our young
Okay. He's mad as fuck.
Sorry about my father. But whatever he says, he's the one who's really suffering since he lost his power. That's why I wanted to ask you this question.
Yeah, I could bring it back.
Well, that's exactly how it all happened in my dream.
For now. For now.
Oh.
Very, very convenient dream.
Only the daughter of the great Galda Rasha could know a thing like that.
Let's just get out of here. Let's just walk out this door. And continue to the next place. Frame drop like fuck. Yep, but I've seen worse frame drop like this, so. Whatever. God damn it, I have to go all the way around, then go all the way inside again. All the way to that door, then go all the way to the waterfall, then go all the way inside and kill monsters, and go all the way back here. Well, I don't actually have to go all the way back here because I can use evac, but you know.
Magnificent. And if this Galda Rasha gets his powers back, there's nothing he can't find, am I right?
Then he killed
two birds with one stone.
Or one bird with two stones. Oh, goddammit.
Find out where that hateful Dulnagus is. The time is getting on. Medea and I will stay outside. That's the last time we set foot in a barbaric town like this. But you should spend the night at the inn and rest well, so that you're ready to take on the world tomorrow in the morning.
I don't know about take on the world, but I can go to sleep. That's my thing. Nee, 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 nee. Good morning, sir. Did you get this? There was dogs that can't be sure, but I figured little old man you came with slipped in his wagon or so. Tell me. Yeah, anyway, have a safe trip. Right there. I'm getting out of here because time to get to working, boys. Not that way. Let's get our asses out of here. I'm on, sir. I was starting to figure I got lost. Wait, let's go to what if I can see if we can find Mr. Ball. Medea and I will be right behind you. If you have any troubles, feel free to consult us. I'm sure there's stuff we can solve if we put our heads together. Away we go! Alrighty then, here we go. So now, we are going to the Waterfall Cave, perfectly outside of the town, where a perfectly crystal ball will be lying, and had a convenient dream about it. Yep. Great. Do you think you could take me on, little slimy slime? See? Look what happened if you try to take me on. And open a chest to me. Let's go. I'm gonna explore a bit later on. So, see you guys now. First thing first, we need to fix that finger glitch. Because I'm getting quite annoyed about that. And slimy slimes again, let's kick their asses. Yeah, perfect. Fire all of Amor, very good healing item actually. I usually train to level 8. In here. The reason is just because I feel like that's the right level to stop at. But I might actually just do it to level 5 or 6 this time around. Then after we try to farm a new levels off screen to level 10. And then we continue from there on. Oh damn it, stop dropping chests. Hell no. And what the fuck did you get on the bridge? Looks like you found it. Naturally I'd love to come in with you, but I couldn't possibly put Biddy in danger. I'm sure you do a fine job of finding the crystal ball without us. Monsters will be waiting here. You be careful in there. I can't say be careful and awesome. So there is nothing around here. But you can see a very convenient chest down there. And we make mischievous moles. Shine, just die, just kill yourself. Jump off the fucking sides of this place and then kill yourself. And I level up. Let's see our stats. 3 HP, monster's attribute, improved. It's pretty okay. Gengos. 2 HP, very bad. Oaken club, oaken shitting club. That fire I'm holding in my hands. looks very conveniently squared off from everything else. But whatever. And the map of the boat, what the fuck cave? Seriously, right in front of our nose. Stop it, stop. We can't go there, so we have to go this way. Little glitches here and there. And we'll meet some drakies here. Let's just take them all out. Oh, damn. Oh, damn. Stop it. So, yep. They're all being defeated right here and right now. And he's down. Chimera wings. Pretty not good because I already have like 20 of them, but whatever. I came and look at the waterfall and I stumbled upon this cave. A waterfall cave is intriguing. I was trying to explore, but I got myself completely lost. Yeah, not very convenient for you, man. And another cameo wing. Yay! Let's open this chest. And medical herb. And leather helmet or whatever. I would call it leather helmet because that sounds better. Dancing devil. Oh. Right in the kitchen, whatever. We can continue a bit down to the next area, then we go around train there. Because this area doesn't have the most powerful enemies. The best enemies to fight, if I remember correctly, are the mech birds thingy leafing. They're pretty good to fight. For a secret. And fire spirits. These ones are pretty annoying. They can actually do high damage on you. Yep. Damn it, fire spirit, stop it. Yeah, they have very high defense against melee weapons. God damn. Fire spirit defeated. Monster level up. Yeah, now we're talking. That's some good stat. Oh yeah, that's that. I like that stat. And we got healed, huh? And I like that. It's better than the last level up. Fire of Amour. I guess that's okay. Where the hell are we going in? Oh yeah, I forgot. Oh damn, I forgot fast. We're gonna fight that guy over there. Might do one or two battles here before that fight because... Because I don't wanna fight him at level 3, so... Ow. And fire spirit and everything in the whole game is defeated. Oaken Club and Fire of Amour. Metal slimes. Too bad I ain't any metal slimes in here. I will fight you right now. You goddamn fool. And skippers, ahoy skippers. Actually, I'm thinking of Warcraft 2, you know, whatever. If you anybody remember Warcraft 2, that is. Because Warcraft 2 was one of the best RTS out there, and if you don't know what that game is, then go play it. That's all I can say. And we got the bunny tail. We gonna need that for a thing later on. Let's just run around here. See if we can get into a fight. Then there, if I had used those 5 to upgrade courage, or no wait, the courage on youngest is whatever the other thing, and youngest, I could have learned something called whistle, and probably a really convenient attack or spell or whatever you want to call it, which makes you able to fight better directly. God damn it, guys. Just kill him. And this is like 2 attacks. Great work, great fucking work. And the Nusk pretty defeated, and a level up. Yay! And we learned Squelch. 2 skill points. 2 skill points. Yeah, let's get this to 9. Eh. 3 skill points. Humanity. Okay. So when we get this to 5, we'll learn the whistle skill, and I'm gonna take it because it's really convenient to have it if you want to level up in a few places later on. There are a few places you can find metal slimes, they give you really high amount of, you know, XP, so I'm gonna have to use that whistle stuff later for that. So make a mini ass. Yep, let's just attack. It feels like I don't have equipped my real weapons. Because I do not do the high amount of damage I thought I would do. Let's go look. Let's go and look. Nope. I don't have it on me. Great. But we will do out. Where's the copper sword? Copper sword. Good, not even I don't have the copper sword. I'm pretty sure we bought that. God damn. 19.8. Stop it. Well, still the damage is way different, so I'm gonna use that. He has it mulled on, that's why it does so much damage. But the weird thing, I'm pretty sure I bought the sword. I don't know why it's not here. So, yeah, bullshit. I call that bullshit. Whatever, I got the boomerang instead then. It's not great, but at least it does more damage than the sword. I thought something was wrong with my damage when I noticed that when I did 8 damage. I should do like 13 damage. Ooh. Take on anybody you want. Psych up. Will all of you use psych up? Nope, here with the attack. Yeah, pretty good. as you can see, we got some good amount of damage now. Good amount, but at least better than, you know, the less damage I had. So if I upgraded my stats to 5 with the boomerang, I probably would have done like 15 damage instead. I might do that after this. Or after I level up 2 times. I'm gonna level up 2 times, yes. I know it's gonna be boring seeing me running around here. But you know we're gonna need to do it. We're gonna do it eventually. So why the fuck not do it right now and fucking get it done? So you can just run to the boss after this and kill him. Dancing fox. Okay, let's kill this dancing fox. Dude. Blaze. Something very convenient I was about to say. Now, if Yang says his guy, he will actually two people, everybody in the party, or enemies. He will actually hit every enemies if he had a Skype. I think it's the Skype that does that. So, and the Skypes skills are really good, really, really good, really good. But the Axe got the really good skills too. So I don't know which one I'm actually going for. Because I'm really thinking of that we're gonna need buffer on dead. Great. And Django's level up. Pretty good. Oh, we got pretty good stat there. Let's take 2 there. Oh, now we got the whistle. And now I gotta show you the whistle. Instead of taking 2 hours, you can do this. See how easy that was. So I think they cost MP. It died 1 hit. I think it's MP to use the whistle. I think it does. And here I level up. I'm going for level 6. Like I did on my other playthrough. My other character. Yeah, I know. I should have created that one, but you know. Actually, I'm gonna borrow 1 seed of skill. Whatever. So you can get the boomerang up. So we can level up. So when we level up one more time, you're gonna, you know, get more damage up after I level up next time. So. Eat my boomerang. I'm gonna have to sell all those shits. And fire spirit appears. Damn. So as a fire spirit that has around 11 HP, I think. I wish I was that good with the boomerang. God damn, we have many of those. And more stuff. I don't think I need healing. And a skipper up here. One skipper, right. That's not any point, because fighting one isn't really helping much. Still 12 XP, but... stop it. Stop it! God damn! Okay, so new enemy, bubble slime. Not very strong, but... what the hell did you do? But that's why I hate it. Because of the poison. Haha. They're all defeated. As you guys can see, this is what I do at level up, and I used to do this in this place all the way to 10. Yeah, and that takes really long time. Let's see how many has only one, so... huh. Gonna transfer those to him so that we, when we fight the boss, he has the healing, because the main character can't get hit by one of the moves he's gonna do there. So that means that Yangus will have a turn he won't be able to attack in. So and Marshivius Mole. I should have probably killed the one over to the right side, but whatever. Yay, battle won! But no level yet! God damn it. Oi oi, skipper! And at level 10, with sword, he learns Dragon Slash. It's not that strong, but I actually used that against the boss of my other character. Not the other character, but, you know, at the same. How long are you gonna take? Dancing fox again. Just die. Level? Nope. Low level yet. Let's just do this. Oh, damn. At least that one is dead. And that one is there too. Right, right. 20 XP. Okay, we'll level up. Nice. Yeah, nice. Come on, more. And we don't evac. Okay, that's pretty good. Now we can evac from any dungeon whenever we want to. Boomerang skill. Prove basic boomerang combat techniques. Learn the cross cutter throw. Great, great. and maximum entry MP and strength 3. Huh. That's pretty good. And perfect 10 here. Increased by fire when you equip a club, blah 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 blah. I should probably not level up club that much, because I probably won't be used to clubs. So yeah, I should not appraise so fast. I might have looked like a pillar came along earlier, but when you saw me run away without saying a word, and as you probably realize, you have to fight me if you want to go any further. What do you think? Brave enough to for that? Yeah, I'm really, but wait. Really? You're brave. That means you must be a good fighter. That's... I could not read. I know, a recognition of your bravery, I'm gonna let you through. Hey, worse. Off you go, be careful. God damn it, pussy. I'm fighting you, I want to kill you. I want to crush your soul. So I'm gonna psych up for damage. Psych up. And now we're gonna attack. For 9. Great. Let's continue. He won't say anything good either way. If we take, actually, I don't have the sword, so I could go get the sword right now, I think, if I go this way. And the skipper up here. I think I need to have it on 10 to get the 5 increase in damage. So to level up to 99 this game, it's gonna take seriously a high amount of work. Cause takes forever, that's all. We got the cup sword here. Nice. Very convenient. And now I'm gonna transfer that motherfucker. And I'm gonna go out. And I'm gonna go here. And we're gonna. As you can see, let's see. 13 damage, 19 damage. But the thing is, you do more damage with this one. Or should I? Actually, I never used boomerang. So just for the sake of this playthrough, I'm gonna try to use the boomerang for fun. But at least we got copper sword exchanged whenever I feel like it. So you can either way buy a better one later on in like few. If in like 2 hours gameplay, you can buy a really good one. Great. Die scum. Oh, you gotta kill everybody. Yeah, we're gonna sell every little fuck that there is. Yeah, we're gonna do stuff like monster arena and shit later on, so. I both died in one attack, great. I'm not really gonna say this, but I think I'm gonna do Rogue Galaxy after I'm done with this playthrough. Rogue Galaxy is a pretty good game. I like it. I like it a lot. Same people made this game, so... But the monster designs and stuff like that isn't the same. It's like Akira Toriyama, so... God damn it. Let's go, because this takes forever to run. I don't know why they made it this far. Did they do it on purpose so you can fight battles on the way over there? Yes, I'm pretty sure they did that for that. And no damage taken. I wonder if we're close to level up. But whatever. We're gonna get into a fight just before the ball. Yep. God damn it. It dodged my attack. The weapon I'm actually going to use in this case is probably going to use spears. So... The moment of truth. Yeah, I don't think so, man. Monster is gonna do that, and he's gonna do that. Because of this move. That's why. Ow. Stop it. Let's use a heal. I could have waited for another move, but... state of high tension. Dragon Slash, I would trace an axe in the air and plunge into the enemy. Youngus is gonna suck up once. Don't use Cursed Mist, and he used Cursed Mist. Great. I usually have another move here, double cut or whatever it's called, hit twice, and I usually kill in one hit when I'm at 50 with that. So, and now, god damn it, god fucking damn it, whatever, whatever, we give him some handicap. And healed up. Great. Evaporates before hitting. Okay. Crest cutter. Ow. And geyser is defeated. Whatever. 100 XP. Monster leveled up to level 7. Oh, nice stat! Just what I wanted. So I'm gonna do this just so that we have a 10 on that. And we're gonna do. He got 4. Should I? Yeah, let's do this. The waterfall hears many rumors. Very convenient, huh? The hands. Yep, and the first boss is defeated. So we're gonna do evac. Seriously. First off, we're gonna heal. Where is the MP? I'm gonna use that so I get my MP. Nope, they didn't give me MP back. God damn it, I have to run all the way out from this place. This is so fun. God fucking damn it. I wish I could, you know, use the skip button here. But that won't work because 20 damage. Nice, nice. One damage. Wait. Seriously, seriously. More XP for me, but still. God damn it. How can I not have any MP? What the hell? Last time I had like 10 MP. But then again, I only used 2 Dragon Slash. Last time too, so. Just die. And let's get out of this shithole, whatever. Come on, give me more items, please. Give me more, you fucks. Not there, this way. And the battle again. I wish I could speed this shit up. I should have bought MP thing, anything. But I didn't think that we need it. Too late now. I guess I have to sell those shit offs. And then there is the Colosseum. Not Colosseum, it's. What's it called? Whatever, there's something later we're gonna have to do. Pair of boxes. God damn, who wanna use devil boxers? Let's get the hell out of here because this place sucks right now. Probably gonna do no. You can actually make pretty good once you unlock the alchemy pot. You can actually make a pretty good good boomerang. I think it's called, might be metal boomerang, might be, but I think that's pretty too early to make that, but it's a boomerang. I'm pretty sure there is a boomerang you can make early in the game. Those Chimera wings though, holy shit. Which way? Let's take this way this time. Man, I could really take a pizza right now. Big, fat pizza with cheese and bacon and a little sauce and a very strong sauce that makes you take a dump in like 20 minutes. That's what you need. Then I won't XP anything, but. Misbehaviors. Yep. Well, once we're out of this place, we can actually use Chimera Wing, so we don't have to walk all the way back to the city though. So. God damn it. Defeated. Those armor amour thingy. It heals 60 HP, so they're pretty good. So now we can use the Chimera Wings. We got 41 of those, so we use one, go to February, whatever it's called. And we are back in the city. But before saving and quitting and all that, I will actually do the main quest, then after that I'm gonna save, so.
I knew you would return before long. And it seems you have done as Valentina asked. You see, even with a glass. Meddling in matters that do not concern you, and you are wasting your time. You can bring back my crystal ball as many times as you like, and you just throw it away again. What? Don't throw things in the waterfall. It might open up an old wound. What on earth are you talking about? No one. Even Valentina has no idea. I'm not about to confide in a stranger. Give it to me! This time I will smash it into a million pieces, so it never finds its way back to me again!
He's mad. He sounds like Super Mario. Crap.
It's all right, Father. You're a good man. You took me
That's that. And we are up.
So you are awake at last. It is already past midday. You must have been exhausted. Thank you and your friend. Look, I have put my crystal ball back where it belongs.
Yeah, I could see that, man. God damn it.
Let me look at these. What's this? Yes, no question. This is definitely my old crystal ball, but look here. It has been shipped. Good. It must have hit something very hard to do this damage. And look, someone has scratched some letter next to the chip. What? Halfwit? Who's the halfwit? What ignorant lowlife would do this to my crystal ball?
God damn it, that finger.
What else you could see? I didn't mean on the ball, I mean in the ball. Whatever. I'm coming, Gov.
Whatever. Because, as you can see, the finger is okay now. But it's only in the CG thingy. So let's go inside and save the game. For all these years I played this game, I always want to try to play this game without saving and let the game just stay on. So guys, I hope you like this new let's play and hope you like it. That's all. I don't have anything else to say, but thanks for watching guys, and I hope you see more of my videos. See you all around, guys.